This is the world's second smallest thermal imaging camera. Second smallest. Why would you shout about it being the second smallest? It should either be the smallest or you just don't bother talking about its size. This is the ThermalMaster P2 USB-C thermal imaging camera, and I'm going to be having a look at it in action and seeing how it compares to the competition. So thank you to ThermalMaster for sending me the tiny little P2 camera to have a look at. I'm not even joking when they declare this as the world's second smallest thermal camera, it's even written all over the box. But it's okay because they also claim to make the world's smallest as well, the P2 Pro. Look, I don't know if either of those claims are true, but I don't think it matters. The camera is tiny. It comes with a little protective case and a carabiner so as you can clip it to your bag or something so as you don't lose it. So you could argue there's such a thing as being too small. This version is USB-C and works with Android phones only at the moment, but an iOS version is on the way, they tell me. It will also work with laptops, Mac and Windows, and comes with an extension cable, but I'll talk about that later. To get it up and running, you just need to download the ThermalMaster app from the Play Store. Plug the camera into the bottom of your phone and off you go. You can tap the colour scheme button and actually choose from one of many different colour themes that are available, like white hot or black hot or iron red, which is probably the one that you're most familiar with. When you're in iron red mode, you can actually enable the on-screen scale by going to settings, tapping scale, and then it will show you a useful key and the range of temperatures in view. You can take still photos with it and record videos too, which are both pretty bog standard features that you'd expect. You can pinch to zoom too, but be aware that this is a digital zoom function only, and it gets a little fuzzy the more you zoom in. So look, how does this stack up against the other thermal imaging camera that I reviewed, the Topdon TC002? So let's start with the price. ThermalMaster's store is in US dollars and they're charging $199. The Topdon TC002 is $240. In the UK, you get that for about £209 on Amazon. Both cameras have the same image resolution, 256 by 192, and the same frame rate of 25 frames per second. The P2 has a wider supported temperature range of minus 10 to plus 600 Celsius, compared to the Topdon that can only go up to 550 Celsius, but the Topdon can go down to minus 20. The P2 is slightly more accurate too, plus or minus 1.5 degrees Celsius compared to the Topdon's 2 degrees. Where the P2 is a clear winner here though is its size and weight. It weighs less than a third of the Topdon. It's clear that the P2 is a much smaller and lighter camera. Both are pretty compact to be honest, but the P2 is ridiculously small. All of that counts for nothing though if the image quality is no good. So let's put them against each other head to head, record the same footage at the same time and see what it's like. So I thought the best way to test these two thermal imaging cameras side by side was to actually put them side by side. So I've sort of crafted this special camera holder so as I can have both of them pointing at the same thing at the same time. They're both recording, so I'm going to put their video streams on the screen at the same time now. So let's point this at some different things and see what we can see. Well, I've put the radiator on so we can actually see the difference in quality there. The Topdon is making everything look quite purple, but on the ThermalMaster it really pops out. The radiator shows us a totally different colour, so there's a very different approach to the way that they're using the colour schemes on these cameras. If I point up at the infrared motion detector up there, it's a lot clearer to see it on the ThermalMaster than the Topdon. It's kind of hidden on the Topdon. It sort of merges in with the background. You can clearly see that on the Topdon, it shows the outside being colder, so that's probably a bit better, but it's still very visible on the ThermalMaster too. And then if I point down at my cat, she's obviously quite warm and you can see her paw prints on both of them. So I think that on balance, the ThermalMaster P2 is slightly better. The image is clearer, as you can see here looking at my cat. If I'm looking around at cooler things, then the Topdon picks out the detail of individual objects better, but as soon as something warmer comes into view, then the ThermalMaster spots it a mile off. So far, I've only shown you the camera being used on an Android phone, but this camera also works with normal computers. At the time of putting together this video, there is no official software from ThermalMaster, but I got this working on my MacBook using a bit of software from the App Store called XCapture. The app is very basic. It will only show the video feed in a white hot colour mode, and you get this night vision style green version too, which I assume is a special heat data that the camera software can't process. But you can clearly see the differences in temperature. Over on Windows, it's even easier. Just plug the camera in and open up the built-in camera app. That's the one you'd usually use to show your webcam. You can select to use the thermal camera instead of your webcam, and the video feed is then exactly the same as on the Mac. So you're probably familiar with the common uses of thermal imaging cameras that every video goes on about, checking insulation, dodgy electrics, that sort of thing. But did you know that they can be really useful in school science lessons? Well, my sister happens to be a secondary school science teacher, so I sent the camera to her so she could use it in her lessons. The thermal imaging camera is a great way to show how different types of surfaces absorb or radiate thermal energy in different ways. They use a Leslie cube, which is basically a cube that has different coloured surfaces on each side. There's a matte black side, shiny black one, matte white, and so on. Normally, a school would use a specialist infrared detector that would give you a number representing the intensity of the radiation, but with the thermal imaging camera, you can actually see the difference. So which one should you go for then? Well, the Topdon's app is a lot more polished. It's slightly more user-friendly too. But the ThermalMaster P2 is cheaper. Forget that it's smaller, that doesn't really matter too much here, but it's cheaper and it gives you a clearer image. So if it's the choice between these two, then I think the ThermalMaster just about wins on those 2 points. Anyway, I hope that you found this useful. I'll stick links to the product in the description in case you want to take a look. These guys here are my channel members, and a big thank you to them as always for supporting the channel. If you'd like early access to my videos, then check out the link about becoming a member in the description. Please give this video a like and don't forget to subscribe to the channel for free to see more from me. Thank you for watching. Goodbye.